You can stand to lose a few pounds. Hello everyone, my name is BFC, and today we're going to be continuing the RushJet Adapter Only Run. It's a mouthful, I still haven't come up with a better name for it. Today we're going to be taking on Blizzard Man stage. The first apparent Robot Master to show off the stereotypical country-based system in this game. Seeing as none of the Robot Masters in this game were created by Dr. Wily, and all of them were created by other scientific geniuses around the globe. Blizzard Man is considered to either be Canada or Russian. I prefer Canada because somebody's gotta be named after my country. This stage really starts to give you the feel that the game is much more open than any of the past Mega Mans, giving you small, diverging paths, and a lot of open space to maneuver using the fly. The theme for this stage is pretty well thought out, I have to say. There are curling stones, there's a lot of ice, there's snow, and better yet, there are these little pillars that can be destroyed using Flame Shot. Not sure where shields fit in, it could just be some retarded form of a hockey goalie. I'm not going to criticize it that much. Oh, hold on a second, I have to do something. And that's how you dodge stupid shields. Maneuvering in this stage is much harder than you would think it would be, and it looks hard enough to begin with. The shield guys have a bigger hitbox than you would expect. Dodging them is extremely hard. As for this guy, this will be a recurring boss for the entirety of the game. This guy likes to be used. He acts somewhat like the pig guys from Mega Man 5 shooting missiles, but he also shoots an ice block. This brings us to my favorite part of this stage, this submarine. Possibly the HMCS Victoria. Could be a Russian submarine, I don't know submarines. Probably not the best place to showcase the jet, seeing it's essentially an upside-down crusher section with spikes at the top. But, yeah. Nowhere else to really use it in this stage other than the beginning. Now, the jet adapter doesn't seem very useful at this point. There are not that many Robot Master stages where it will be apparently useful, like extremely apparent. In this though, as you can tell, you can just fly over the mini boss, ignore it, and then continue on. It'll save you from a lot of stupid jumps into pits as well. I don't know why, but bombs seem to be loved in this stage. It doesn't really fit for the theme, though. I like them, don't get me wrong, and they did continue. But I'm not sure how that works with snow and ice. Here we are, to Canada slash Russia Man himself, Blizzard Man. He has two things he'll do. He'll roll up into a ball after slightly moving towards you, or he'll spawn four identical snowflakes that will come in a random pattern, all diverging on your original position when they formed. They can come from anywhere on the stage. Now, dodging Blizzard Man when he rolls at you, simple as it can get. Dodging his four snowflakes when they randomly decide to spawn all four on top of you, it's much harder than you would think. Actually, just about as hard as you would think. All the boss fights are more endurance runs than anything else. If you're cocky, you can do that and decide to float in the middle of them. I wouldn't suggest doing that. You're probably just going to end up getting hit by them and then flying into Blizzard Man himself. Hope you enjoyed this run. If you liked it, stay tuned for more, as always.